very unfortunate that four judges of the highest court of our country have come out with a public statement through the press. I wonder for what purpose. Who will decide the issues raised by the judges? Do they expect that the people at large will decide, which cannot be done? Or the parliament would decide that is not proper, although the constitution does not provide for it, and parliament also cannot exercise its jurisdiction, which the constitution does not confer. And then what is the purpose? Do they want that the executive should intervene in this matter and sort out problems amongst the judges of the Supreme Court of India? I think these issues cannot be gone into by anybody except the judiciary itself. Therefore, I think this is a very, very troublesome situation for India and a very sad day for our democracy as a whole and for judiciary itself.
हमारे राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष स्वयं यहाँ आए, उन्होंने इस घटना को इतना महत्वपूर्ण माना है और इसका जो संबंध है, जो जुडिशरी की इंडिपेंडेंस से इसका संबंध है, उसको महत्वपूर्ण मानते हुए वो स्वयं यहाँ आए और उन्होंने ये संकेत दिए हैं कि ये विषय महत्वपूर्ण है और ये विषय क्योंकि सुप्रीम कोर्ट कि इंडिपेंडेंस से संबंधित है, सुप्रीम कोर्ट के सभी जजेस को बैठ के इसको तय कर लेना चाहिए।
इश्यूज लाइक सेलेक्टिव हंटिंग ऑफ बेंचेस एंड रेफरिंग सेलेक्टिव मैटर्स बाय द चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया टू जूनियर जजेस इन ए सेलेक्टिव फैशन, इश्यूज लाइक पेंडेंसी ऑफ 3 crore केसेस येट नो जस्टिस फॉर द कॉमन मैन, इश्यूज लाइक judicial propriety being compromised and certain orders being given in a particular fashion as stated by the 4 honorable judges. It is the onerous duty of each one of the citizens in the government to ensure that an immediate and an amicable redressal of these issues is done at the earliest. And I think the entire country should be interested in upholding the equanimity and the majesty of the highest court of the country, for that is the last refuge for every Indian.
The things are not going well and it should be sorted out internally, and also something is wrong there, it should be set right.
It has shocked the whole nation. And in fact, it has rocked and shaken the very democracy and the constitutional institution, Supreme Court of India, the watchdog of democracy itself. I am shaken, I am anguished, I am pained, and the intensity of my pain is triple. Number one, as a concerned citizen of India. Number two, as an officer of the court who's practicing law for over 4 decades. And number three, as a lawmaker myself, as a member of parliament, accountable to the people of India for what is happening around. Now, what has happened is unfortunate. It should have been avoided, although the learned judges who have come out in open have already made it clear that when they were left with no alternative, they had to resort to this public address.